Hey teachers, I'm going to show you how to do something really important today. This is something all teachers need to be using, no matter what grade or level you teach. This will benefit your students, but mostly it'll save you time. Yep, you need to make a lesson website. On your website, you can make a page for each lesson in which you can put YouTube videos, links, images, and much, much more. This has been a lifesaver in my real and e-learning classroom. Now, I know what some of you old school teachers are thinking, but I don't have time to learn new things. Well, we didn't have time for a pandemic and that didn't stop us. And now you don't have time not to do this. So the first thing I need you to do is go to your Google Drive. And in Google Drive, you're going to see your square menu dots. You're going to click on that and a list of apps will show down beneath that. And you're going to scroll down to where you see sites. You're going to click on that and you're going to see something similar to this page. Now on the left where you see the red create button, you're going to click on that and it's really important that you click in new sites recommended. Click on that button. All right, now that we're into our site, let's get going and let's make this our home page right here. So what we're going to do first is we're going to title this. So I'm going to say this one is Miss A's class, and you're going to put that in here, put your name in here. All right. And we can go ahead and change the design in the background. I'm not going to spend a lot of time doing that, but you can upload your own picture or you can select from ones they already have. And I'm going to scroll down the page and I'll select this one right here. You can even change the font by design by going over here where it says themes on your right. You're going to click on that one. And you can scroll down, see what they have. Ooh, impressions. All right, I'm gonna go with that one. That one looks pretty good. And now if I go back over here, I'm gonna go where it says insert, where it says insert pages, themes. I'm gonna click on the insert button and I'm going to drag this one over, or you can click on it and it will appear right underneath. And I'm just gonna make a little welcome message. So I'm gonna say, welcome. I'm gonna say, welcome to your class. Here you will find your assignments and lessons. And then underneath that, you can put down your email address. You can say if you have any questions, contact me at, and then below that, put your email address on there. And then over here, let's put a picture of ourselves. Let's go to upload. And now it doesn't have to necessarily be a picture of you. It can be a drawing of you. It can be, you know, something that is inviting to the kids, something that the kids will be like, oh yeah, that's my teacher. There we go. I'm going to use a Bitmoji icon. I'm going to put that one on here. And oh, look, it's a little bit cropped. You can't see all of me. So I'm going to pull that one down a little bit more so you can see me on here. Oh, perfect. There we go. And here's our welcome page. Look how fast and simple that was to make. This is our homepage right here. So let's get down into the lessons of it. So you're going to go back over here where it says pages. And we're going to go down to this little plus button and we're going to go to new page. So click on that little plus one. And this page is actually your classroom. So whatever classes you teach, English, math, science, drawing, I have drawing one. So I'm going to put down drawing one on here and say done. Now this one is my classroom and I want to put the lessons underneath this. So when the kids scroll over to drawing one, I want to have a list of my lessons down and so they can click on that and see what they're supposed to be doing. So I'm going to go over here where it says drawing one, this little page thing, and you're going to click on those little three dots and you're going to go down to add subpage. Now the subpages, these are your lessons. So I'm going to say lesson one, and this is going to be the survival drawing kit. All right, so here we go. And I don't really like this font, so I'm going to double click on this one. I'm going to go down here, go to heading. There we go. It's a little bit easier to read, I think. All right. And now the first thing I want to do on here is I want to do a little introduction to the assignment. So let me go back over here to the insert button. And I'm going to just click this one. It has a little picture. It has this click to edit on here. I'm going to put down survival drawing kit. And now I've already gone and copied my lesson, like the things I want my kids to do in order. And I'm just going to paste that on here. So I'm going to go down, paste. And you can see I have everything from like the 1, 2, 3, and I have a little bit of an introduction right here. So I'm going to take off that first part and I'm just going to go down here and I'm going to take off the rest of this because I don't need any of those yet. I'm going to put those in a little bit later. So here we go. All right, that looks nice. And now if I don't want to put a drawing in here, if I'm like, oh, never mind, I just want it to be the title, I can click on it and I can go to that little trash can looking thing and go delete tile. Then I can pull this all over. So I can pull this one over. And if I want to be centered, I can click this little thing and it'll center it. So same thing with this one too. I can click the little centering thing and that'll center it all for me. Nice. All right, now I have a really nice introduction to my project. Then underneath that, I'm going to put down my first part of the lesson, the first part I want them to do. So again, I'm going to paste in my lesson and I have the whole thing on here. So it's going to take me a little bit longer because I got to scroll through. I already did the introduction, so I'm going to delete that part. So number one is brainstorming. I only have three steps on here. So let me get rid of that. Perfect. So one, brainstorm. So I want my kids to make a list of 10 items that they need to survive the pandemic. So they just need to list them out. And then they're going to think about how they're going to do it. And I'm going to actually put in a little example for them. It'll help them out on here. So I'm going to go to upload. And here is my list. Now you can see I need to pull it down so it'll all fit on here. All right, survival kit drawings. So I want to make sure you can see the number. So maybe I went a little bit too much. There we go. So we'll get drawing examples. Perfect on there. So that's the brainstorm. So that's number one. And let's go ahead. And I'm going to click the little button over here for layout. So we'll add in another one for me. I'm going to go back under here and do the same thing that I've been doing, paste. So the second one is to sketch out your ideas. So let me get this one off here. Take these ones out. Sketch out your ideas. Let me add that too. All right. And then let me put another picture in here that kind of relates to the sketching thing. So I'm going to go to upload the kitty cat open. I want to make sure that you can see my image. So I'm going to do the same thing again, right? Just pull it down here. Yeah. And then the last one. So I'm going to go back over here under layouts. I'm going to add in the same layout. And there's tons of different layouts you can choose from. I just like this one. It seems to work really well for me. I like how it goes down in order. It tells the kids exactly what to do and which steps on here. So brainstorm, sketch out your ideas. And number three. This one was just like turn it in. So I'm going to write in three, turn it in. And on here, I'm going to say turn in your worksheet in Google Classroom. And then on here, I can even put the worksheet on here. So I can go to from Drive, search, survival drawing kit. There it is. And I can insert that right here. And this is the same worksheet that I want them to do up here that I have to fill this out. So I can add in a little button. And this will act as a link and it will take it right to the worksheet I want my students to do. So another way of doing this is by going and finding your worksheet. So here it is right here. And I've published it. So I went up to File, Publish, delete the part that says edit on it and put down copy here. Click on that and I'm actually going to copy that link. Come back over to your site. I'm going to paste that here and I'm going to call this Survival Kit Drawing Worksheet. I'm going to insert that one here. So that'll make a copy for each one of my students. And you can see it showed up down here at the bottom and I want it up at the top. So I'm just going to click and I'm going to drag it all up here. I'm going to hold down. And I'm going to put it right in here because I want them to start filling out this part of the worksheet, the brainstorm ideas part. And actually, I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so they can see the whole thing on here. There we go. And turn it in. So my kids are going to brainstorm ideas. And there's my ideas over here off to the side that I did for them. And here's their worksheet that they're going to fill out. So they're going to start putting their ideas on the worksheet. And then they're going to start sketching them out. And then they're going to turn it in. So their sketches are going to go on here as well. They're going to upload their sketches onto that worksheet. Now, the other thing I made for them is a YouTube video. I did a video of my own sketches that you can kind of see right up here and how I did it, talked a little bit about my technique, and I also talked about why I chose the things that I did. So what you're going to do is you're going to back up here to Insert, go to YouTube, And you can search for the video, and I made something called survival kit drawings. And this one right here, select. Here we go. So the kids can watch the YouTube video that I've made for them, or you can select any YouTube video that you just see online that you want them to watch. And also, I want them to be able to see these pictures really big, so I'm going to make an image carousel. So that means that I'm going to put in my images on this, and they'll be able to click through and make them really big on their screen, just kind of like a gallery. Down. I have a gallery of images here that the kids will be able to click through, and then I have the YouTube video up here, and again, you can always go back through and change the size so it fits the screen however you want it to fit it. I really appreciate that feature that Google Sites lets you do on here, and it tells the kids everything they need to do. So I think this is perfect for any teacher to use. I don't know why we haven't been using this before. When teachers see this site and how I've organized it for the students, they love it. And it didn't even take me that long to do. And now I can use this for all of my classes, whether it be, you know, e-learning or not. This is perfect. It steps my kids through everything I want them to do. And now all I have to do is take this and link it to my Google Classroom, and I'm ready to go. I don't have to link in the video, the pictures, the worksheet, the steps, nothing. Everything is all together right here. And parents appreciate this so much. If they're helping out their students on these assignments, they can look at this and they know exactly what their kids need to do. So this is something for you to think about. I highly suggest doing this, and let me know how else I can help you. My email is in the link below. Oh no, one last thing. Don't forget to publish it. You want to make sure you publish your site the web, that way your students will be able to see it.
I'd love to see the lesson site that you've made. Leave a link to it in the comments. And remember to always publish your site.